What's up, fans? It's KP. I am styling at the Long Beach Comic Con with Phil Ortiz, one of the creative geniuses behind The Simpsons.
No! I was associated with The Simpsons from season one, which was way back in 1989.
Right.
Ever since then, I've been the main penciler on The Simpsons comics for the last 17 years. I just finished issue number 176. I think it's going to go over 200 easily. But so, even if the show is canceled, the comics go on.
Yeah.
It's a labor of love.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's a lot of work, but I can't help thinking that The Simpsons is the best gig I've ever done because I have been with them so long. The first season of The Simpsons was the best year of my life because it was an experimental show. We didn't know what direction it was going to go in because it was just a one-minute spin-off on Tracy Ullman's show.
Sure.
We had two chances to present to Fox a Simpsons half-hour show. Now, the first show panned. It didn't do good.
No!
Because we had artists from different studios working on the first episode of The Simpsons.
Mm-hmm.
So you had different styles for people from Disney, from Warner Brothers, Hanna-Barbera.
Right.
It just didn't make sense. So Fox shook their head and said, nope, let's bring on the next one. So they had the main director on the Tracy Ullman show handle direct the second episode.
Mm-hmm.
So it had more consistency because he had the feel of the characters.
Right.
And that one passed. There was a lot of experimentation during the early years because we had to set up everything. We had to set up the entire town of Springfield, mm-hmm. all the other incidental characters, along with the main characters. It was starting from scratch.
A lot of work, right? Even
a
had
lot
those,
of work.
Those secondary and tertiary characters.
Right. It evolved, just like Mickey Mouse evolved into what it is. The Simpsons were very crude looking, and it was an animator's nightmare, meaning that Matt Groening's style of The Simpsons, he just whipped something out in about 10 or 15 minutes, presented it to Fox. Fox liked it. But Matt's style was very angular, a lot of points,
uh-huh.
and it is very difficult for an animator to animate a lot of points. Mm-hmm. So we kind of softened it up throughout the seasons until it appears as it is now.
Right.
The writing is what makes it successful, cohesive.
Mm-hmm.
It's still controversial, but people are used to it because they have been around it so many seasons, it's numb their senses practically. That's the essence of The Simpsons.
Yeah.
I mean, it wouldn't be The Simpsons without the controversy. And like after the first season, we got a lot of letters from church groups, from There was this one letter I remember from an employee at a nuclear power plant, and he wrote in and said something like, "Hey, I'm not like Homer Simpson. I don't put my feet up in the on my control desk and let the plant melt down." You know, he was really ticked off. And the Simpsons are an equal opportunity offender, so you know, nobody escapes the wrath of the writers on The Simpsons.
Hey, thank you so much. It really was a pleasure to finally meet you. You know, I see the name on the credits, and it's nice to put a face with the name. Thank you so
much.
Thank you.
Keep watching the show. Keep the ratings up and keep me employed. That's all. That's all I ask.
I and our fans will do our best.
Oh, terrific. That does it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the man, the myth, the legend, Phil Ortiz. I'm KP, live at the Long Beach Comic Con. More to come from Long Beach, California. I am Stylin, stylinonline.com. A little geek fan stardom thing I got going on with you.
Okay. Called me and asked me if I wanted to start on the comics. They were just going to start on the comics. So I said, sure. Couldn't have called me at a better time. I only had 2 weeks of work left. So. But there are a lot of knockoffs now of The Simpsons shows. I won't mention their names, but China, where The Simpsons are banned, but they still get leaked through the internet.
Yeah, right. Thank you for your good work.
Oh, you're welcome. Just for saying that, you can have a comic here. I'm charging $25 for autographs.
For me, $27.
Yeah, there we go.
Battlestar Galactica.
Batman.
Serenity.
Boba Fett.
Highlander.
The Empire Strikes Back.
Doctor Who.
Star Trek The Next Generation was my favorite.
Scooby-Doo.
Well, at the moment, it would be True Blood.
True Blood.
True Blood.
I have to say True Blood, too.
She-Ra.
Doctor Who.
Star Wars, Episode 4.
Firefly, without a doubt.
Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Joker, obviously.
Family Guy.
Good choice.